Greetings, students. In the last video, we have seen the problems on pipe connected in series. Now, in this video, just see the problems on pipe connected in parallel. The main difference between pipe connected in series and pipe connected in parallel is when the pipes are connected in series, the discharge remains constant. But whenever you are connecting the pipe in parallel, so the discharge does not remain constant. And when we can say the pipes are connected in series, only when the main pipe is divided into number of pipe, two or more pipe, and at the end it will be again form into one pipe, then and then only we can say the pipes are connected in parallel. So here in this case, this is the diagram already given with the numerical. So here it is given that the main discharge Q is there, which is divided into two discharge Q1 and Q2, and the main discharge is given and we have to find the discharge in the these two pipes, that is Q1 and Q2, we have to find. So just see what data or what is the numerical given. The main pipe divides into two parallel pipes, which again forms one pipe as shown in figure. The data is as follow. First parallel pipe, the length is 1000 meter, diameter is 0.8 meter. Second parallel pipe, length is 1000 meter and diameter is 0.6 meter. That means the length is same, but the diameter is different. Now the coefficient of friction for each parallel pipe is 0.05. So remember, whenever the pipes are connected in parallel, the loss of heat due to friction will remain same for both the pipes. That means HF1 is equal to HF2. Now what is the formula for HF1? It is 4F1 L1 V1 square upon 2G D1, which is equal to 4F2 L2 V2 square upon 2G D2. Now lastly, if the total rate of flow in the main is, now this Q is 2 meter cube per second, find the rate of flow in each parallel pipe. That means we have to find the value of Q1 and Q2. Remember, there is a nothing change apart from series. We have to use the same formula, just the way is different. Now here in the piping series, we are adding this losses, that is HF1 plus HF2. If the two pipes are there, but here we have to just equate that HF1 and HF2 to find the unknown. So firstly, write down the given data. So for the pipe 1, the length is given 1000 meter, the diameter D1, capital D1, is given 0.8 meter. For pipe 2, the length is same 1000 meter, the diameter D2 is given 0.6 meter. Now the coefficient of friction, that means this is the value of F given. So F1 equal to F2 equal to 0.005. Remember, I am telling you one more time, whenever it is mentioned coefficient of friction, that means in this formula only the value of F is given. If here it is mentioned the friction factor, so that is nothing but the value of 4F. So you have to write in the given data as 4F. But here they have mentioned coefficient of friction, so it is only F given. And lastly, the main discharge is given, capital Q is equal to 2 meter cube per second, and we have to find the discharge in each pipe, that is Q1 and Q2. So the first step is write down this HF1 equal to HF2 formula, because if you see this formula, we have to simply use Q is equal to area into velocity formula for the Q1, and for the Q2, A2 into V2. But the velocity is unknown. So to find the velocity, we have to use this formula, and we have to form one relation of, as we are doing in the series, as one velocity in the form of another, and we have to place it here. So the total discharge Q is nothing but Q1 plus Q2. Here is the two discharge. So main Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Now firstly, write down this relation as it is and cancel out the things which are common. And nextly, so 4F1 L1 V1 square upon 2G D1 equal to 4F2 L2 V2 square upon 2G D2. So if you see, the four friction factor is same, so it will get cancelled. The lengths are also same, so that will also get cancelled. 2G is common, so that will get cancelled. So only thing remaining is V1 square upon D1 equal to V2 square upon D2. Now So form the relation in between that. We are knowing the value of D1 and D2. So just place here the value of D1 is 0.8 and the value of D2 is 0.6. So form the relation as V1 is equal to, do that, first transfer this point at this side, then you will get 0.8 upon 0.6 V2 square. Do this calculation and we will get V1 is equal to, if you take the square root, 1.15 times V2. So the relation between V1 and V2 we got. Then nextly we have to just this put this relation in the discharge formula. So Q1 is equal to A1 into V1. So A1 is nothing but pi by 4 D1 square. Remember, we have in the syllabus only circular pipe. So whenever the area is coming, the formula you have to use is pi by 4 D square. So for pipe 1, it is pi by 4 D1 square. And the velocity value in the form of V2 is 1.15 V1. So put here. So you will get 1.15 V2. Do the calculations and at the last you will get as 0.283 V2. That means after cancelling this all things, putting the value of D1, you will get this relation. Q1 is equal to 0.578 V2. Similarly, do this for Q2. So A2 into V2. So you don't need to do any calculation. So just put the value of pi by 4 D2 square V2. So you will get Q2 is equal to 0.283 V2. So two relations we have, one for Q1 and another is for Q2. So we have again one more equation which we have written previously. Q is nothing but Q1 plus Q2, and the main discharge is known to us. Now we have both the values of Q1 and Q2 in the form of V2. So just put this value of Q1 and Q2 in this equation, you will get the value of Q, you will write afterwards, 0.578 V2 plus 0.283 V2. Now Q is known as, 2 is given 2. Now just do the calculation, and after that, after this step, we will get the value of V2 as 2.32 meter per second. So once you get the value of V2, then just find out the value of V1, because we have knowing the relation V1 is equal to 1.15 times V2. So V1 is equal to 1.15 into 2.32. So we will get 2.67 meter per second as a V1. So as the velocity V1 and V2 are known, simply find Q1 is equal to A1 V1, which answer we got is 0.342 meter cube per second, and Q2 is equal to A2 into V2, which gives answer 0.658 meter cube per second. So this is the simple formula or simple steps to solve the pipes connected in series. In the next video, we will see the combination of both which are asked in the exam, whether combination of series and parallel. Thank you.